everybody, it's Jenna with the Elkhart County SWCD, and I am so excited because as you can see behind me, it snowed last night, and I want to do an experiment with you guys. So the first thing we need to do is collect some snow. So follow me, let's go. All right, so the first snow that we're going to collect is something that's clean and hasn't been touched except for when it was in the sky. So here it is, I've got some clean snow, and I'm going to take one of my cups here. This is going to be my control, and I'm going to fill it up with snow. And just like flour, I've got my snow here. I don't want to pack it down, so I'm just going to kind of swoop it off the top there like that. So for this next one, I'm going to get it from the same spot. It's going to be clean snow, but I'm actually going to pack it into the cup. So I'm going to squish it as if I was making a snowball, and I'm going to put it in this cup and get the same amount. So here you can see I've packed my snow in here, I've squished it down from the top, and now I'm going to go get some more snow. Alright, so I'm out here in my yard, and the next sample that I want to get is off the top of the grass. So I can see the grass poking through the snow, so I'm just going to go ahead and fill this cup all the way to the top. Careful not to pack it in this time, and then I'm just going to level it off with my finger. That way we've got the same amount of snow in each cup. Alright, so I'm out here by the roadway, and they've already plowed this morning, and I've got a pile right behind me where they pushed it off the road. So I'm going to take a scoop of that, and then I'm going to level it off just like the other ones. Alright, so that's what this one looks like. We're just going to kind of level it off here. Got a few big chunks there. Alright, now we're going to take it inside, and we're going to let all four of them melt. While our snow is melting inside, let's talk a little bit about how snowflakes are formed. Up in the sky, we have itty bitty tiny dust particles, and then we also have really cold drops of water. And what happens is these water droplets are frozen to the dust particles and they form crystals. Now, as that falls down to the earth, it actually picks up more crystals or more moisture from the air. And then that's how the snowflake is built. It's multiple crystals formed together. All right, so now that our snow has melted, let's take a look at it, all right? So first we have our control group right here. This one was full when it started. And now, there's hardly any water in there. Our grass, same thing. There was hardly any water in that cup. And our packed one, if you compare our control with our packed, there's a lot more water in there. And our roadside snow has quite a bit of water in there. But if you look, there's a lot of sediment in there as well. So let's talk about why that is. Why do we have such a little amount of water when we had a full cup of snow? Well, think about when the crystals are formed, there's spaces in there. And between each crystal or each snowflake, there's going to be even more space. So when the snow melts, all those water particles are closer together. They're more condensed. It's kind of like if you breathe on a mirror, the water in your breath condenses on the mirror. So let's look at the color of each of these. Now, it's a little hard to see on the video, but our control, even though it was clean snow, it still has a few tiny particles in it of sediment or dirt. Our grass, once again, it's kind of hard to tell in the video, but it has a little more particles than our control does. And our packed, it has some particles in it, but not as much as the grass. Now check this one out. That's about half full of sediment, and the rest is going to be water. Now, I don't know about you, but I don't think I would want to drink that water. So let's think about, why is there so much sediment that was found on the roadside? Well, if you've got bare soil, like either on a field or a construction site, when you drive off of that site, you're going to track mud onto the road. And so then when it snows and the highway department plows the road, it pushes not only the snow off of the road, but the sediment that was on the road as well. And this is why it's so important to keep the sediment off the roads, because when that snow melts, it turns into liquid form of water. And when that water is running off of the road, it carries with it the sediment. But not just is it carrying the sediment, it's going to carry all the pollutants that are on the road as well, including oil or trash. We're right by the landfill, so we get a lot of trash in our ditches. And it carries all of this off of the road and then into our waterways. Now, if you think about it, in the summertime, if you want to go playing out in the river, you're probably not going to want to go play in the river after a rainstorm, because all of the pollutants are washed into the river after it rains or after it snows and it melts away. Well, guys, I hope you learned a little bit in our experiment today, and I hope you have a snowtastic day. And as always, thanks for watching!